Hey, what is that folder right there?
We are aware of various types of pollution, water pollution, air pollution, noise pollution, and etc. All these kinds of pollution can be measured and quantified. But have you ever heard about visual pollution? A certain forms of pollution affect our aesthetic sense and are very difficult to measure and define. This type of pollution is called aesthetic pollution. Visual pollution is one of them. The effects of visual pollution are increasing tremendously from day to day. Visual pollution is a term used to describe something that blocks the view of something. It refers to everything that affects or disrupts sight. It is an aesthetic issue, meaning that it disrupts with the ability to appreciate the beauty of a specific thing. Visual pollution can be in our environment without us realizing how much it can affect us, such as trash cans, reflected light, advertisement, electric wire, and graffiti. Prevention of visual pollution. Visual pollution can be prevented by the collection of solid waste from the street to care for the aesthetic of open space, the maintenance of buildings, especially in the remodeling of the cadent buildings, reducing the excess of advertising on the open space, and planting trees on the streets and avenues, also turn off high beams when they are not needed on the road. For remediations of visual pollution, major ways to solve visual pollution is education. Educating people the issue and effect that their actions have can change their activity. Government actions also accounts for the solving of this problem, like controlling vandalism, increasing fine, manage construction and area. Global scale of visual pollution. We cannot measure visual pollution precisely, but according to these research papers, they show that visual pollution has become more problematic to many parts of the world. As this paper stated in abstract concerning public space including both urban and rural areas, its regions face similar problems which are present in public spaces. The difference between each area is their system management, such as wastewater management, physical waste management, influence of commercial size, and the development of each area. For example, think about the urban areas that are already developed and the others that are still developing. There would be more commercial size in developed area than others, while waste management would be less efficient in developing areas.
Okay, that was very interesting. Hey, what is that sound?
You don't have to be a drummer in a metal band to be impacted by excessive noise. As per a 2014 study on auditory and non-auditory effects of noise on human health, the everyday sounds of the industrial age can degrade entire sound frequencies. Yet, we are talking about the omnipresent urban backdrop of screeching cars, honking trucks, sirens, heavy traffic, airports, and more. Noise pollution is anything unwanted or disturbing sound that affects the health and quality of life. Noise pollution is commonly generated inside many industrial facilities and some other workplaces. But it also comes from highway, railway, airplane traffic, and from outdoor construction activities. The intensity of sound is measured in decibels. The more intense the sound, the higher the decibel count. Then, how many decibels is too long. According to WHO, sound levels higher than 85 decibels are dangerous in long-time exposure, such as heavy traffic, and at 120 decibels, such as sirens, even short exposure can do damage. Let's try to listen this clip here. Although sound at approximately 85 decibels does not damage your ears in the short term, but listening to it for a long time can cause some damage to your ears. Prevention of noise pollution. The state and local governments should have proper laws that prevent noise pollution near residential and school or college areas. For example, vegetation along roads and in residential areas is a good way to reduce noise pollution as they absorb sound. Remediation of noise pollution. There are no definite solutions to the noise pollution, but there are many measures that could be used in order to control the noises and manage the problem, such as creating regulations that support the corrective measure like this one. Separating the residential area where people live from the industrial area, which usually produces noises. Global scale of noise pollution. According to a European Union publication, about 40% of the population in EU countries is exposed to road traffic noise at levels exceeding 55 decibels. 20% is exposed to levels exceeding 65 decibels during the daytime, and more than 30% is exposed to levels exceeding 55 decibels at night. Only limited international features are available on the health impact of environmental noise in the European region. WHO Europe published preliminary estimates in 2011. Nuisance at night can lead to an increase in medical visits and spending on sleeping pills, which affects families' budgets and countries' health expenditures. Regional scale of noise pollution. Much like visual pollution, many regions face a common problem, which is the sound of transportation and construction. But construction problems would appear more in developing areas, and transportation would depend on the public transportation system. Consider Japan, for example. Their public transportation is a major way of transportation rather than using cars.
I believe that everyone wants to enjoy the scenery and peaceful environment in their life. But right now, the conditions are not optimal for us to enjoy it. It is not just someone's fault. Everyone has to take a step in the right direction in order to improve our world and get rid of this pollution. Let's help each other out. Starting by today, every day here on out will be a brighter day as every person helps each other out. The world will change drastically in the future. I hope you guys understand more about both visual and noise pollution. Thank you for watching and hope you all have a great day. Enjoy the views.